I'm in my mom's car. Broom, broom. Get out my car. Aww. I'm in my mom's car. Broom, broom. Get out my car. Aww.
Hey guys, what's the biggest number you can think of?
Trillion, billion, zillion.
That's pretty big. How about you?
10.
Okay, how about you?
Infinity.
Can you top that?
Infinity and one.
Actually, I was looking for infinity plus infinity.
What about infinity times infinity?
No.
It's not complicated. Bigger is better.
Is there a Netalai in here? Netalai?
Touch me, Natalie.
No, I mean Natalie! Natalie?
Don't you mean Natalie?
No, I meant Natalie! I've been teaching for 8 years. Now go see Mr. Haser.
Who?
Mr. Haser!
Mr. Hacker?
Get the heck out of here!
Yeah, make sure you get the heck out of here.
Alright, moving on. Now that Natalie is here. Is there a Ryan in here? Go.
Freeze it.
Finally!
My name's Dr. Phil, and today we got someone with a strange addiction to keychains.
Well, this isn't an addiction. It's actually a great deal.
How much do you pay for all them keychains?
It's only $3.
Only $3?
Why lanyards? Why do we have to have them, and what's so important about them?
Lanyards. And when we look at lanyards, I think it provides another level of security to a very large high school. We have close to 2,400 students on campus, in addition to over 200 faculty and staff members. And I think it's that level of security that lanyards provide in any large environment. And I think if you look at society in general, in many workplaces, it's just a matter of principle to have your identification present at all times. But we also look at lanyards in a different way, from a standpoint of accessibility to other things involved with Brownsburg High School. In the Senior Academy, seniors need their lanyards to print documents. Seniors in the Senior Academy use their lanyard to sign out in the main office in the Academy. And hopefully we'll have that trend in our team offices very soon, where it gives us a much more accurate sign-in and sign-out process for our students. In the Media Center, you need your lanyard to sign out materials for educational purposes. So it's that level of security, but I also think that it's a level of accessibility to the things that we offer students as well. So wrapping that all around, it's, wow, why lanyards? Why is it such a big thing? Yes, it's great to be to identify, oh, they're a member of the class of 2017, but it's all the other things that they provide, and that's just, it blends and goes very well with what society expects in this day and age.
Last night was open house night at BHS, and I was there to catch up on some of the attendees and ask them about the event.
Do you think this year at Brownsburg High School is going to be a good experience for your child?
Absolutely. I think having the Senior Center kind of separating from the rest of the group is good for the kids to kind of get an early experience of like what a college life would be and kind of get a little more maturity and a little more experience.
How do you feel walking in your child's footsteps for a day?
It's been a long time since I've been in the halls like this, so it's a little intimidating to meet some of the teachers and see the kind of things that he has to do and so forth.
Why do you think it's important for this night to be here this night?
Well, I think it's always important to make sure that we talk to the parents, okay, and the parents get to see what's going on in the high school, and we don't have it very often, so it's not like we ask parents all the time, but when we do, we want to basically show our case, our wares,
And we also really, you know, want to talk about what our mission is, and that is to give the kids the most personalized education that they can have.
Do you think this night helps with
very
the parents?
Much. Very much. Much so, yes. All right.
Why do you think it's very important to be here tonight?
Just that I have an idea what the teachers are looking for. Sometimes students don't share, and just gives the parents time to meet the teachers and know what they want from the or expect from the kids.
Thanks, Mason.
Some new freshmen here at BHS and asked them how they felt about their new school.
So, what aspects of freshman year do you like better than middle school?
It's a lot more freedom.
So, a lot more freedom.
I like gym, like, every day.
I like how we have more freedom.
What part of high school do you not like or find negative?
I don't like how we have gym every day.
It's a lot more crowded than middle school.
How small the lockers are.
So, how do you like your freshman year so far?
Yeah, it's big and cool.
I love all the beautiful girls!
My freshman year is going pretty well, for the most part, yeah.
So there you have it. We've interviewed a couple freshmen to get their opinion, and yes, they were just as awkward as we were. Back to you.
Tomorrow is September 11th, a day that will forever be remembered by Americans after the attacks in 2001.
We caught up with some students and staff at BHS and asked them what they remembered about that day.
Where were you at when September 11th happened?
I was in 8th grade, and I was actually taking my I-STEP test at Fegley Middle School in Portage, Indiana.
How much do you know about 9/11 in general?
Relatively quite a bit, I'd say, just from teaching about it and reading about it. So I know one of the strategies that was taken was that they needed to use the commercial airline jets because it was twofold. Really, one, for affordability, obviously they don't have fighter jets of their own, but two, it was also to send a message to the United States that they could actually infiltrate and use our use the things we trust most.
Adam, how do you feel about 9/11?
I feel like it was a very, very, very sad time for our country.
Labor Day was just this past weekend. We asked some BHS staff and students what they did during their Labor Day weekend.
So the first Monday of September is over, Labor Day has come and gone, our 3-day weekend is over. So what did you do for Labor Day?
I was very lazy yesterday, watched movies with my family, and took a nap.
Do you happen to know what Labor Day actually is?
I believe it's a day where you honor the people in the country that have worked, the working people of the country.
All right, so our 3-day weekend has sadly come to a close. I'm sitting here with Mason now, and now tell me, what did you do for your 3-day weekend?
I didn't do anything.
It's very surprising. Now, do you actually know what Labor Day is?
No.
Thank you. We'll figure out here in a little bit. All right, I'm here with Jack now, and tell me, what did you do for your Labor Day?
Well, surprisingly, I worked on Labor Day at a golf course and watched people golf on their fun Labor Day while I sat there and had to work.
That's very surprising, people actually working on Labor Day. That actually leads me to my next question. Do you know what Labor Day is?
To be honest with you, I don't. But I would love to know.
Labor Day is the first Monday in September. It is dedicated to the economic and social achievements of the American workers.
Isaiah asked some of the BHS teachers and administrators about the NFL season.
I'm here with Mr. DeGay. How do you feel about the NFL upcoming season?
Well, I'm looking forward to the games. You know, I think that's September weekend, first weekend in September. And traditionally, I like the Colts, follow the Colts. Being from Illinois, I like the Bears as well. If I had some dark horses, I'm looking for the Chargers, and I like the Eagles.
And Coach, how do you feel about NFL the upcoming season?
I haven't watched a whole lot of it yet. The preseason I don't get too much into, but once the regular season starts, I'll dive into it a little bit more. All I know is that my Chicago Bears are going to be pretty good this year.
I'm here with Coach Tower, and Coach, how do you feel about the upcoming NFL season?
Very excited, ready for the Colts season to come this way. So,
how do you feel about the upcoming NFL season?
Well, I'm really excited about the upcoming season. I feel like Tom Brady was very underrated, so I'm really excited for him to exceed everyone's expectations and have a dynamite year. I'm excited.
Mr. Jones, how do you feel about the upcoming NFL season?
I'm always excited when NFL season starts. Every Sunday, I find myself parked in front of the TV enjoying some snacks and watching the grown men beat each other up. It's always a good time.
This is the Drive for Your School event. Bill Estes Ford sponsors. Folks that come out and drive, we'll have over 300 drivers today. Ford donates $20 for every car that's driven. And so there's $6,000 right off the bat. And then the Brownsburg Education Foundation has found other generous sponsors that donate additional money. So every time someone drives a vehicle, it's $55 that's donated. So we'll get about $15,000 a day donated to our schools and the Brownsburg Education Foundation. Those funds go into the Education Foundation. They support scholarships to our students. The Education Foundation has given over $1 million back to teachers for grants and students for scholarships since they've been in existence. Bill Estes is one of our huge community partners. This is just one of the many things that they do for us, including the football field at CF Roark Stadium at the IU Health Complex. And so we're very fortunate to have such a community-minded partner like Bill Estes.